The flagman got the one to go signal in his hand. For the first of four, B Mains being contested on the third of a mile, high banked oval. We will see what we can make shake out. Coming out of turn number four, they drop the green flag. Here we go. And the turns one and two, they go. Joseph Jordan jumps up to an early lead with the number 13 of Scott Cook to follow up behind him. Here comes Adam Cummings trying to work the inside of Cook as they work off turn number four. Lap one is now into the books. Jim Rogers trying to get up under the 61 machine. Only the top three advancing into the show. But the battle for second getting real good as they come to the strike with two in the books. And down the straightaways they go. Joseph Joyner, used to that very slick track down there, Milton, Florida, known as Southern Raceway. Trying to take advantage of that know-how and make it work here to the Alabama Oval.
Slip, that's for sure.
Yeah. Very much so. Continue to click them off. We are now three laps into this one, seven to go. Jim Rogers right now, one of the cars eligible for a provisional. Out of the cars competing in this first of four B mains. Halfway in, halfway to go for the field. Jim Rogers still fighting, trying to find some grip on this track. Lucas Burns in the number 27. Trying to get down to his inside as Russell Brown race car continues to slide around on the speedway. Something not right on Jim Rogers' car as he has finally faded back to the final position with seven laps in. Only three laps left in this one. The bullhorns are out, two to go for Joseph Joyner. Scott Cook, Adam Cummings are the two in the rearview mirror of the number 10 with the white flag out. The 51 machine of, Mr. Brandon McCollum, the first guy looking out, hoping one of those guys up front will make a mistake, but flawless victory for Joseph Joyner. He takes the checkered flag, Scott Cook second, third to Adam Cummings. And Brandon McCollum will be the first car looking out. So David Sieber is probably trying to play a little possum with the field.
He was riding the brake.
Sievers, Stewart is your front row. Tim Boucher, Ted Moore, the next two. Out of turn four, they're gonna try it again. Here we go. Well, David Sievers was ready that time. He just jumped all the way in front of Douglas Stewart. Dylan Ted Moore is gonna battle with the 22 Boucher for the third and final position. He shuts the door and he locks himself in. But the number 22, wow, he just used that bumper and moved him out the way. Dylan Tidmore automatically falling back to Boucher. Boucher has no points on the 2016 tour so far, so he has to race his way in. Dylan Tidmore trying to work the top side is just a little bit slick up there. It's going to force him to fall back in. But Tidmore did make both opening nights at the Cochran Motor Speedway. So he has a couple of points right now in reserve for just in case. Jim Rogers right now, one of the first ones that will have to take one. Ted Moore up on the top side, trying to get it blowed off and get some speed to work for him. But Boucher and the rest of the boys up front just too strong and cannot allow him to close up the gap. Halfway in, halfway to go. David Sievers. Strong performance out of him. Douglas Stewart in the second position. Dylan Tidmore trying to make the top side come in, but to no avail. Oh, and overdrives it, and he's just lost all the ground that he was making up on third place. Seven laps in, three to go for this B-Main. PPM Products B-Main number two. Still getting at it out of turn number four. Two to go for the field as they cross the stripe. So far, Dylan Tidmore cannot make up the gap. Here comes Kit Seeley trying to get up under him. The white rag is out on the field. Still single foul up front. And checker flag for Sievers. Douglas Stewart second. Tim Boucher final transfer position. Dylan Tidmore be the first car looking out. Cruise with the champions, B-Main number three, under wraps. Here we go. David Brizel, your pole sitter. And the caution is going to wave. Oh, whoa, that's getting close there. All right, we're going to try it again. Cruise with the champions, B-Main number three under wraps. Here we go. David Brazil, Dallas Cooper going toe-to-toe. Adam Giles going to get under Thomason for the third position. And again, contact made. And he's going to bring the caution out. And Dylan Tidmore will be watching Brad Skinner. She doesn't race her way in to see if he can lock himself in without using the provisional. Oh, Adam Giles, and around he goes. Great veteran move by. Single foul starts from this point on after three failed attempts to get it going. So we're going single foul. Let's see if Anna Parkhurst can get up on that wheel and race her way into the show. As right now, Dylan Tidmore, I know he's going to root her on. Because if she can race her way in and Brad Skinner can race his way in, Dylan Tidmore will find his way into the show. But right now, the hands is primarily in Brad Skinner coming up on the DirtOnDirt.com, B-Main. Number four. And if Skinner races his way in and Parkhurst don't, she will get the provisional, but good God, she just looked up under him coming to the line. She is driving that car hard. The young 15-year-old young lady got Dale McDowell and Andy McDowell turning the wrenches for that number 23 machine. Tommy Taylor, the Central Tennessee driver, trying to adapt to this very slick surface. As we're halfway in, halfway to go, Parkhurst, she's trying to get to the loud pedal. Four circuits left around the speedway. Parkhurst has closed up the gap. All right, ladies, root her on. Here she comes, Parkhurst to the inside. The young 15-year-old lady trying to make her way into the dance. She's pushing on him coming to the line. Three laps left. Oh, Parkers will overdrive it. That's going to cost the young lady. With two to go, can Parkers grab the bull by the nose and make something? White flag out for your race leader, David Brazil. Parker's time running out for the young lady. Checker flag for Brazil as he takes home. Cruise with the champions, B-Main number three with Dallas Cooper second. And Tommy Taylor will come home third. Parkers will barely miss the show by one position. Row number two will be Brad Skinner, the one that is going to determine if Anna Parkers will make the show. Be Brad Skinner, the points leader, and Jason Wilson to his inside. Row number one, Brad Berry and Mark Bangs will lead the field. Thunder Cars, we need you in staging right now. Thunder Cars, get them to staging. You are next. DirtOnDirt.com, B-Main number four, the wheel will drop. Here we go. And it turns one and two, they go. Mark Bangs with the early lead. Brad Berry falling back. Brad Skinner, you better root him on. He just gave him the root, and he's going to put Brad Berry out of the way.
The Rock Ledge Rocket.
The Rock Ridge Rocket trying to hold on and make the show. Brad Skinner, the Southern All-Star Series points leader, because Casey Roberts will not be able to make this event this evening. He will take over, but he's got to get up and get around the 27. Otherwise, Parkers will not make the show based off current Southern All-Star Series points. Three laps into this event. Seven to go. Up front, your leader, Mark Bangs, the veteran here at the Talladega Short Track, showing the way around the speedway. But you got second place man right there, Jason Wilson of Margaret, Alabama. Another one of these Hornet Nest hot shoes trying to make some way up. Brad Skinner slowly fading back as Brad Berry getting away from him. The Rockledge Rocket rocking away from Brad Skinner. Brad Skinner will make the show regardless off of provisional, but Anna Parkers needed him to get around Brad Berry into the show, but we got something shaping up here on the front. As the battle for the lead is about to get hot into the turns one and two, Mark Bangs finds the drive off turn number two, and he's going to pull away from Jason Wilson as they head into three and four. Two to go this time by for Mark Bangs. The rest of the field taking the two to go marker. Jason Wilson trying something on the top side. Mark Bangs will take the white rag with the rest of the field falling in suit. Justin Jason Wilson has let the time run out, and Mark Bangs will pick up DirtOnDirt.com. B-Main number four. Jason Wilson second, Brad Berry third, and Brad Skinner will round out your top. And Jake Knows, Dylan Ames, and Dale McDowell make up row number two. And the number one starting spots will be Riley Hickman and Jason Hyatt. All right, Talladega, get up on your feet. Get out your cell phones. We're about to make Talladega go viral. Take pictures. Hashtag SAS Dirt. The juggernauts of the Sandlot. The baddest boys with the biggest toys, the premier series of the South. Here are your Southern All-Star Super Late Models. Wave your arms, flap your hats, even wave your mother-in-law. Be sure you keep the babies in the diapers while you're jumping around. Here we go. Back stretch. Same thing for you. And dirt late model driving parking. Get on your feet, back stretch. Let's see those cameras fly. Wave your arms, flap your hats. Upload those videos to Twitter and Facebook with hashtag SASDirt. Lights are out. Talladega short track. Get on your feet. We're going to send them right Bama style. The fail's going to tuck them in tight. 24 the best in the South. In the words of MC Hammer, it is Hammer Time all four. Riley Hickman driving in hard in the turns one and two. But Jason High is going to get to the loud pedal and pull him down the backstretch. In the turns three and four. Two by two by two, they come to the line high at elite lap number one. Riley Hickman fighting for everything he's got on the top side. And making it work up there. He's pulling back on Jason High. They come to the straightaways. The Hustler on the high side. Big trouble in turns three and four. Bang. Caution coming out for David Brewer. All right, here we go. The Delaware double foul coming into play. Riley Hickman trying to stump on that start. Here we go. Riley Hickman trying to make that top side work. They call him the Hustler, the three-time and defending Southern All-Star Series champion. Getting high, wide, and handsome all four. Here comes the Mac Daddy up to third, but Jake knows in the red, number six. Keep your eyes on him as he's going to try to work his way up and pick up that elusive Southern All-Star win that he's been waiting to get for quite a while now. The Hustler, Riley Hickman, trying to make some dig on the top side. Oh, things getting hairy in the backside. Scott trying to hold off the number 22 of Wilson. William Thomas has gotten to the high side. He's a high side motivator when he works around Talladega short track. He is now passing Hitchcock as they get to the straight. Talladega, one of the best nighttime tracks in the United States. Trying to live up to the name. Riley Hickman now going to tuck it to the bottom. Joseph Joyner, Douglas Stewart, David Siebers. That then became a steel cage match. Pushing and shoving and going into turns three and four. Trying to split it three wide. Good race coming out of the Hornet's Nest. Jason Hyde driving into the Talladega moonlight right now while Riley Hickman and Dale McDowell in tow behind him with Dylan Ames and Jake Knowles rounding out your top five as we are nine laps into this 40-lap feature. And Jim Rogers, the DirtOnDirt.com cruise with the champion rookie of the year, going to go down one lap as Hyatt has now caught the back half of the field. As the track slowly getting worked in and coming around. Jake Knowles all over Dynamite Dillon going into turns one and two to battle for third contact. Wow, hard hit by Jake Knowles. The Rome Rocket turned on the Astro Burners and Dynamite Dillon forgot to light the spick and it went blueing in his face. Keep your eyes on Tim Rozelle in the red 25. Right now making up the most ground up positions as he has came all the way back from the 14th position is now up into the top 10. Matter of fact, he's closing up on William Thomas, the 19A machine, who's running in the sixth position. Riley Hickman, the car just a little bit on the tight side right now, but he is definitely hooked up and dialing in. But Jason Hyatt, good Lord Almighty, he has won the last 7 out of 8 races here at the Talladega Short Track. And this is race number 8. Trying to keep the perfect sweep, has yet to win a Southern All-Star Series race after many years of trying. Jake Knows has worked his way around Dynamite Dylan Ames. Now up to the 4th position. And he's coming for Dale McDowell. Bradberry off the pace on the back stretch. He's going to make the hard right and take it over. Jake Knows was fastest in practice earlier. Full straightaway advantage for Jason Hyatt. Jason Hyatt just too strong tonight. 17 laps complete. 23 to go in this one. And Jake Knows, the Rome Rocket is coming up there, and he's about to challenge Dale McDowell. 19 laps complete. Sportsman, we need you to staging. Sportsman cars, your feature's coming up next. We need you to staging. The field halfway in, halfway to go. Jason Hyatt not playing any games with the field tonight. Showing him how to get around the hornet's nest. He has set the whole nest up, and they are buzzing around the speedway. Riley Hickman fading further and further back with 22 laps now complete, with Hyatt hitting the stripe. The field very racy. Right now for Jason Hyatt, he's telling the field it ain't nothing but a gangster party. Got the Tupac in his system, and he's showing out on him tonight. 24 laps complete so far. America's Most Wanted, Jason Hyatt. I don't even think Dr. Dre can fix anything on this one. This guy is completely decimating the field. Dale McDowell now, the Mac Daddy, trying to close up on Riley Hickman. Track getting racy and racier as the laps continue to click off. Great racing so far here tonight at the Talladega Short Track. Riley Hickman dealing with Brad Skinner to try to put him a lap down, while Dale McDowell playing the patience game and trying to work himself around him. Your leaders are all down at the bottom, hugging and catfishing to protect what they got. And again, Jason Hyatt, God almighty, he's just, there's no play down here in the South for him. He's got the hometown advantage, and he's about to serve up some home cooking, Chef Boyardee style. Twenty-nine laps complete. Jason Hyatt leads with Riley Hickman second, Dale McDowell third, Jake Knows in the 4th position, Dylan Knows 5th, William Thomas in 6th, Terry Smith 7th, Tim Rozelle 8th, Todd Morrow 9th, and Joseph Joyner right now rounding out your top 10. Laps left with 9 to go this time by. He's got it all the way up, turned up. The dial has been turned off. Jason Hyatt, absolutely a flawless race for him. Untouchable. Soared through the sky like Michael Jordan, putting a slam dunk on the field. 33 to go this complete, 7 to go this time by. Dale McDowell will put Jim Rodgers a lap down. The Hornet's Nest buzzing hard around the speedway. Dale McDowell knocking on the rear end of Riley Hickman on turn number four. The problem is, can he get the nose right up under the R1 machine? Caution out onto the speedway. Terry Smith, the number 99 machine, coming to a complete slow. Lights are out. They come out of turn four. They're about to pipe it up. Here we go. Five to go in this one. Everybody's swinging down to the bottom. Tim Rozelle's going to take it up top. Look how he just piled around. William Thomas heading down the backstretch. Hyatt's got that car catfishing and digging all the way down in the mud. And Hedgecock, four wide on turn number two. Good God Almighty, they're racing. Three to go this time by four, Jason Hyatt. Hedgecock on the top side. He is riding. He's got the blue man in him, Sonic the Hedgehog. He's fired up, got it into a little blue ball, and he is coming. Now he's after the Mac Daddy. Two to go this time by. Jason Hyatt, he's gonna take the white flag one more time around for Jason Hyatt. Hedgecock and McDowell, contact coming to the line. Those guys gotta square off. Living handsome and wealthy, give it to Jason Hyatt here at Talladega. All the way up, wow, Corey Hedgecock just passed McDowell. We're down here in victory lane for the NASCAR Dega 40. First time ever winning a Southern All-Stars event. Jason Hyatt, man, how does it feel?
Oh, it feels good to get that monkey off my back. You know, we've led a bunch of these things and finished second in a bunch of them. And, you know, just glad to finally get it.
Now, you went out there, you started on the pole. Riley Hickman was all over you on that first two laps where that caution came out. But did you think you pretty much knew you had him covered?
Yeah, I mean, at the first of the race, we was kind of, you know, filling our groove out and just making sure we kind of guarded the bottom there and didn't get ourselves messed up, you know. It was a long race, and we didn't go any softer than everybody else on tires, but we wanted to kind of save our tires at the same time, you know.
So I see that you brought your good luck charm with you right here to victory lane, right?
Yeah, I did. He had to go round up that Southern All-Star hat, you know, before he got his interview, but he's my biggest fan, and he's always here, and you know, it's why we do this, you know. So he get him a go-kart and race and do all that stuff. So I'm just glad that he's a part of this, and you know, that he can come and be happy.
Well, he was at the state race. He held that trophy. So this time he get to hold the big one, right?
He likes those trophies a whole lot. He takes me home, whoops me if I don't get one every time. You know, he's mad about it, but I got to thank Wendell Vincent Race Engines, Joey Phillips, Phillip Properties, NSC Mechanical. I got to thank my dad most of all. I mean, I got a business, and tell you the truth, I didn't work on this thing 1 minute this week, and he done all the work on it. So, you know, I don't always show it and tell him, you know, but it means a lot to me, and I don't know what I'd do if he wasn't here. So this means a lot for him to be here, and we can race together.
Well, we said you're gonna make it on dirt, and you finally got there.
Yeah, we've been there a few times, but it's definitely the biggest win of my career. Just being big race weekend, and man, this is our local track, and it seems like we wear everybody out. But when big race weekend comes, it just seems like we've always got something going wrong, and I'm just glad we finally put it together.
Definitely, congratulations on your first Southern All-Stars win. We hope to see you back with us in Victory Lane soon, buddy.
Thank you, buddy. Thank you.